Welcome to my channel. Today I am back with another purse video. I am going to be changing this wallet right here. We are going to turn this orange color into an autumn red. This is how the wallet looks as of right now. As you guys can see, it's actually in really good condition. It doesn't need any kinds of repair. So what we're actually doing today, it's just switching the color. For this transformation, I chose the autumn red color as an experiment just to see how well this purse is going to take this red color. I was looking into the color wheel and orange and red are right next to each other, so I don't think it's going to be a difficult color to paint, but we are going to have to see as we go. So right now I'm just taking a piece of scotch tape and I am placing it over the corners of the purse where I don't want the paint to come over. Next, just cut any piece of extra tape that may be coming off from the corners of the purse just to make it blend in a little bit better, and that way it's easier to paint. Today I'm going to be using the Angelus brand acrylic leather paint. I highly suggest reading the directions, that way you guys know better how to use the paint and how to apply the coats. I will be using the brush that is attached to the cap, and I'm going to be using it because my wallet is very small, so I feel like it's perfect to get into those details in the wallet. And lastly, I'm going to take this plastic bag so that I don't make a mess in the area that I am painting. So the first thing that I did was use some rubbing alcohol just to remove any dirt or any stickiness that could have been in the purse. This is not necessarily to remove the color. I know I did that in my other purse. This is just to clean it so that I can begin to apply the paint. So in this moment, I am applying the very first coat to the wallet. As you can see, I am using the brush that came with the paint, because I think it's much easier for me to control the amount of paint that I'm applying at a time. If you guys noticed, this wallet has a very interesting texture. It's not a smooth texture, which also helps that I have this smaller brush, because the brush allows me to get into those creases and it allows me to paint a lot more evenly than if I were to use, let's say, a cotton dabber or a sponge. So right now I'm just gonna speed things up a little bit. Notice that I am painting away from the logo, so I'm starting near the logo and painting towards the corner. I'm not painting the entire section all at once in long streaks, because even though I'm applying the first coat, I also wanna make sure that I'm doing it in an organized manner. I don't wanna be completely random and just paint all over the bag. Even if it's the first coat, do it in a way that you can continue to do the next coats in the same format so that you can evenly count how many coats you're doing and applying to that section. Another thing that I wanna note is, do not worry if you get any paint on the logo. You guys are actually going to be removing that with either some rubbing alcohol, some nail polish remover, or honestly any surface cleaner that is not going to damage the hardware. So for the hardware, it's a little bit more tricky. We're going to talk about that later, but right now let's just focus on painting the wallet by section. So you guys are going to see, once I finish this entire section, I'm going to let it sit for about 5 to 10 minutes before applying the next coat. And I'm applying the paint between the logo. Once again, that's really important because you want to make sure that you're painting every part of your bag, or in this case, your wallet. Okay, so the first coat is finally on, and now we're gonna let that dry for about 10 minutes and then we're gonna move on to the next section. So it's been about 15 minutes. This is how the first coat looks like. Notice that once we let the purse dry, we're actually able to see which areas needed more paint. This is really important before applying multiple coats before the paint actually dries. Notice that I seemingly applied an even coat, but then again on the purse itself, there were certain areas that seemed to have less paint than others. So once again, there are going to be areas that are going to be a little bit more tricky, and this is why you need to wait until the first coat dries to see which areas are going to need filling. If you add too many coats at once, you're overloading the bag and you're probably wasting paint. The reason why I like to do different sections at a time, so I'll do a section, wait 5 to 10 minutes, and I'll actually move on to the next section, it's because that way I feel like it's much easier for me to manage painting. And also, if it were the case that I had to paint fully an entire section, so paint that section, different coats, and just stick to it, it might be the case that I might be overloading that section with paint, and then if I touch it with the glove, it might be the case that I'm going to have some paint be removed, and I want to make sure that I don't have that issue. And the only way that that can happen is if you apply thin coats, let it truly dry, and then just move on to a different section. That way you can save time and you're actually making sure that you are properly applying the paint. I know that I'm saying this like a million times, but it's really important to do this. Okay, so now we are painting the bottom portion of the purse. This is the part where you have all of the card slots and all of that good stuff. My only suggestion for this part is to make sure that you paint in between the card slots, or just paint low enough so that you don't have any of the original paint showing. I know that sometimes we forget to paint that part because it looks like it's perfectly painted, but once we open that slot a little bit, you're able to see some of the original paint. So the goal is to make this new color seem like it was the original color on the purse or the wallet. So I skipped ahead and I applied about 2 to 3 more coats. This is how it looks on 3 coats on each side. I did this mainly, you know, due to the time constraint, but this is ideally what it would look like in 3 coats if you guys do the same color on a different purse. There's still some areas that need to be retouched, and you're gonna have to keep doing this probably for the remainder of your painting experience. Once you have applied those full-on coats, you're gonna have to go back and retouch those areas that still need the filling. So this is how I painted over the zipper perfectly. I just applied a piece of tape right on top of the zipper, and that's gonna allow me the freedom to paint over that upper corner where I am taping, and that way it's not going to damage the material. So I went ahead and I removed that tape that we had originally placed on the inner upper section. I had placed that tape there because I didn't want to get any paint on that area, especially because I would be holding on to the purse from that upper section. So I'm the kind of person that when I'm painting, I don't want any paint to get on an area that I have already painted or that I'm not painting. So that really helped me separate each section, and it helped me paint that upper section last. So that's the reason why I use that tape. And this little black thing that I took out, I used that just to protect this inner orange part right here, but that's mainly what I used it for. This is how it looks on the last coat. Even though it looks really, really good, there's still a lot more that I'm gonna have to do after the video. I feel like this inner part right here is still needs more coats, but for the most part the outer part looks really, really good, so I'm really happy about that. In terms of painting this bag, I will say it's a little bit more difficult than painting the other bag that I had. I think this bag was just a little bit more difficult because it was a harder material, whereas the other bag that I painted was more softer and it seemed to absorb paint really well. I would say that that material was full-on leather, whereas this may be some sort of mix. I'm not sure what material this is made from exactly, but I know for a fact that it's not like soft leather. So I think that had to do with the reason why it might have been a little bit hard to paint over. Once you're finished painting the bag, like I did here, you're gonna take some rubbing alcohol as well as a Q-tip or a couple Q-tips, and we are going to remove the paints that dried on the hardware. The reason why I'm using a Q-tip is because it's really, really easy for the alcohol to get on the bag. And even in here, once you look at it, you're gonna see some of the paint coming off. The alcohol is really, really strong. I actually don't suggest using it. I used it because I thought that the hardware was not going to be damaged, but as I removed the paint from the hardware using the rubbing alcohol, I actually noticed that the hardware got a little bit black. So I do suggest googling some alternatives that you can use to remove the paint from your hardware, but as you can see, it's completely possible. I just suggest doing your research and choosing whatever solution that is not going to completely remove the color of the hardware, because I think that using the rubbing alcohol not only removed the paint that dried on the hardware, but it actually removed the gold paint that was on the hardware originally, which we do not want to happen. So I don't suggest using rubbing alcohol. I would say maybe nail polish remover acetone. It might be a little bit better. The best option is to do research, because I would not want you to ruin an expensive purse. But this is how it looked after I used the rubbing alcohol. So it wasn't even that bad. I just did notice that there was some discoloration from the hardware. So be careful with that. Be mindful. Do not use a very high percentage of alcohol, rubbing alcohol. I would suggest just do some research. And there you have it. We have successfully transformed this bag. We changed the color from orange to an autumn red, and I'm actually really excited and satisfied with the results. I highly recommend changing your purses to whatever color you like best and just taking your time with painting the bag. You guys, this is pretty much it. We have reached the end of the video. If you like it, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment, and you guys have an awesome, awesome day.